tonight on Game Night, Aaron, Lincoln, Nikki, and myself, Dave, are going to play Scythe, a game for 1 to 5 players published by Stonemaier Games and designed by Jamey Stegmaier. So, here we go!
Hey, Dave.
You have a question, Lincoln?
I do. Will you teach us Scythe?
I will teach you Scythe. All of us, I mean Scythe. Scythe. In Scythe, we are characters representing our faction. We are trying to make our faction the richest faction in all of Eastern Europe. I need to mention up front that we are playing the collector's edition of Scythe. It includes this extra large board, though it doesn't have extra spaces on it, and fancy coins and some other stuff.
Resources and...
So, if you buy the normal, regular version of the game, it will look similar to this, but not exactly like this. But it plays exactly the same. In Scythe, where do I start here? We are, each of us, as I said, is a faction, and each faction comes with its own faction board. This is the faction board for the blue faction, which is not in use. We are using yellow, black, white, and red.
Bjorn
and Marks, they're actually the Nordic faction, and they would have, these are my yellow colors, but they would have 4 blue mechs that would cover those spots like that. So we each have one of these boards, and then we have a second board. I've actually used the blue pieces here that looks like this. These boards we drew randomly. There are 5 in the game, this being the 5th one, and we each drew one randomly. They all have the same actions on them, but they are in slightly different orders. That'll make sense when I explain it. There are top actions and bottom actions, and we have mixy-matchy as far as which of our top actions line up with our bottom actions. Additionally, some of the costs are going to be different for certain things depending on what we have, and that will be balanced out by this little box right here. This little box and this little box are essentially how you start the game, what you start with. This won't make any sense right now, but the blue faction starts with 4 power, that is indicated over here, and 1 combat card. I, for example, start with 5 power, as indicated by my little power token, and no combat cards. Everybody else has a certain number of power and combat cards. And then, in addition to that, you will start with a certain number of resources. The blue character starts with 2 encounter cards, I'm sorry, 2 objective cards, 2 popularity, and 5 coins. We all have different amounts. Nikki, for example, starts with 7 coins. Mm-hmm. And Lincoln,
6.
Yes, and different stuff. And there's a little small number up in the top right corner here. The lowest number, which in this case is me, because I start with 4 coins, is 1. That indicates that I am the start player. And turns will essentially start with me and then just keep going clockwise around the board until the game is over. So, what is a turn? Turn is, you will take your little action marker, which will start off for purposes of the beginning of the game, but you will place it on one of these 4 spaces on your player mat, and that will indicate which of the top actions you are going to take, followed by which bottom action you may or may not take. So let's talk about what some of the actions are. We all start the board with a character and 2 workers on the spaces adjacent to that character on the board. All right? We all have what are called units in the game. A unit is either a worker or a character or a mech. Mm-hmm. So when I refer to the word or you see the word unit, that means that. But the units themselves have different functions in the game. So let's start here. If this is the produce action, the produce action costs this, which in this case is nothing. These are 6 more workers. We all have 8 possible workers we can get to the board. And when you basically put a worker to the board, you pull them off from the left, and hey, you can, I don't know if you can see that, but that is a power, so that once you get 2 workers, 2 more workers to the board, taking this produce action now costs you a power every turn. And 2 more workers, it will now cost you a power and a popularity. And 2 more workers, a power, popularity, and a coin. Produce is pretty much what it looks like. I'm just going to take these off for now so they're out of the way. Produce is pretty much what it looks like. You're going to pick 2 hexes on the board. that you have workers in, and you are going to produce on those hexes. So in the case of the beginning of the game, there are only two for me. So I'm going to produce on this hex and on this hex, and for every worker in that hex, I will produce whatever this says on the little iconic thing. This is a food, and this is actually another worker. So if I were produced here, that would be that. If these were all here, and I produced on this hex, and I would not have, in this case, a second hex that I would produce on, I would produce three food. When you produce something, it goes on the space where you produce it. Resources in this game never are in front of you. They are never technically yours. They belong to whoever controls this space, which is very likely going to be me, especially back way back here on the edge of the board. These will likely always be my spaces, but they might not be. Similarly, when you are going to spend resources, which I haven't gotten to yet, you pull them from the board in spaces that you have. So if for whatever reason this looked like this, and I needed three food for something, I could go, well, there's one, two, three food. These are three spaces I control that have food in them, and I put them back and I spend them. You are not resource limited in the game. If we run out of these, they give us little like tokens to indicate, hey, there's more of these. So that's what the top action of produce does. I'm gonna explain the bottom actions later. I'm gonna do all of the top actions first, okay? So that's one thing you can do. Another thing you can do the trade action. For the trade action, you will pay a coin and you will get any two goods that you want, or this line indicates or if you want, you can pick up a popularity. I'll explain those later. You can trade any, you get any two goods you want, and you put them in a space where you have a worker. So they can be two of the same. I can take two oil, or I want an oil and a wood, and they both go in any space that I have a worker. All right? Mm-hmm. That's what trade does. It's pretty simple. Bolster, you pay a coin, and you either move up two on the power track, or you take a combat card, which I have not explained. That's what bolster does. And finally, move. So when you move, I'm moving that out of the way just so you can see it. When you move, you can either move twice, which is to say two pieces once, or you can gain a coin. So when you move, let's talk about movement. Everything moves one space. In this case, this movement is not one piece twice, it is two pieces once, okay? Movement is pretty simple. You can move into adjacent hexes. Your character can also move. This is your home base area. You can never move into a home base area, not just your opponent's, but your own. So moving back there is not a legal move. You cannot cross water in this game until you are allowed to. Water in this case being these spaces that are lakes, but more importantly, these rivers actually block. They are rivers and you cannot cross them until you have the ability to cross rivers, which I will get to in a second. The mechs, when they move, can carry with them any number of workers. So in this case, there's only one in this hex, but if, say, there were two, they could both go along with this mech. And now let's say I chose movement. This would move one space. That's one. And then for my second movement, this guy could go here if I wanted to, or this guy could go there if I wanted to, because I have still, these guys have not used their movement. Does that make any sense? Mm-hmm. That would not be the case here if I moved this mech there, because this guy could not move further across this river, right? That's a restriction. The workers are not allowed to cross. They have to be carried across.
Right.
Any of your units can take with it any number of resources. So the workers or the mechs or the character that you have can carry with it resources from the space it's on to the space it goes to, all right? And a mech can take as many workers as you want, mm-hmm. not just the one that I happen to use in the example.
Okay.
All right? When your character moves into a space that has this little encounter token, it must stop its movement there. Now, at the beginning of the game, we're only moving one space anyway, but as the game progresses, there are things you're going to be able to do to move more spaces and faster. So there are two things that will actually stop your movement. One is if your character moves into a space with this encounter token. And the second is if you move your character or your mech, either carrying workers or not carrying workers, into a space where there is another player's units. Okay? Let me lift this away for a second so I can see the whole board. So that will stop your movement. Additionally, another way you can move are through these tunnels. There are six on the board, and they basically all connect to each other. So if I were starting in that space with any of my pieces, I could move here for one, and I could move there for one. Additionally, if this were here and I had two units of movement, I could go one, two. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the tunnels allow you an additional way to move around the board. Okay, so that is movement. If your character, since I mentioned this token, if your character, not your mech and not your worker, if your character is in a space with an encounter token, at the end of your movement phase, even if this stops my movement, I still must spend all whatever movement I have before this happens. And if there were combat, combat is what happens when you are two different players are in the same space, that would resolve first. After all of that happens, we then do this encounter. This token is removed, so it's a one-time use, and you draw a card from the encounter deck. And an encounter, an encounter has three things on it. The first is, I believe, usually free. In this case, it's gain a food and a popularity. You can do one of these three things, basically. This is pay $2 to gain three resources, and this is pay a popularity to gain a worker and three metal. When you gain these things, popularity, obviously, you just move up on the chart, but when you gain resources or worker and metal, they go on the space with the encounter token.
Got it.
Okay? So that's where that goes. And I didn't actually read the flavor text, but we will read it when we do it.
And there the beautiful art.
The beautiful art. There are definitely, there's flavor text for what you did to get those things.
The flavor text is funny on most of mine, I think.
On your faction board, when you build a mech, under each of these mechs is an ability. And when that ability is uncovered, because you have built that mech, you now have it. We all have the last ability on our boards is all the same, which in this case is speed. It's plus one hex per movement. Note, these only apply to your character, that's this little horse icon, or mechs, so not workers. But when you do a move, all of your characters and all of your mechs on the board would get one extra bit of movement. Again, movement is only two things anyway, or a third if that cube isn't there, which I haven't gotten to yet. But your characters and your mechs would get an extra one. We all have the same fourth one, and we all sort of have the same first one. It's called Riverwalk, and it's the ability to cross rivers to two different types of terrain, and that's what's different for all of us. So let me not do the blue one. For me, for example, if I'm able to expose Riverwalk by building that mech, I can then move across rivers to reach farms, that's this land, or tundra, that's this land. Nikki's will be two different terrains, yep. or at least one different terrain. We'll all have a different mix match set of terrains.
So you'll never be able to cross a river into that forest because
Correct.
Yours doesn't have
And
that.
Remember, this is not between farm and tundra. Mm-hmm. This is crossing into farm or tundra. So if I were here, I could move to this tundra space from this mountain, but I then couldn't move back to this mountain. I could, however, move to that farm if I needed to.
Got it.
So that's the Riverwalk. And then the two middle powers are different for all of us. And I think the easiest thing to do is just explain them when they happen, if they happen. You might not even build all four of your mechs.
Right.
One more thing about movement. If you move your character, and only your character, into the factory space in the center, you are allowed to then pick up these factory cards, we took five cards, players plus one, from this deck of factory cards. This deck is now not used for the game. And we put five here. They're all good. And the first person there essentially gets to choose one of five. The next person would then choose one of four, assuming that we all get there. So the last person would choose one of the last two. And what a factory card is it's just an extra space you can use as an action. It adds to the end of your mat. Mm-hmm. They are all different on the top. They're all good. They're all pay something to gain something. Pay something to gain something, pay something to gain something, pay something to gain something. But the bottom action on each of the cards is a double move. It's one, it's not move two things once, it's move one thing twice, or if you had speed and you were moving a character or a mech, move one thing three spaces. Those are all the same on the bottom. They're all movement, okay? And the reason that that's important or can be crazily helpful to you is that, and I didn't explain this yet, is that on your next turn, whichever of these actions you chose, on your next turn, you must take your action pawn and move it to a different space on your mat. Meaning, if I've done this action, on my next turn, I can only do one of these three. Right? Those are the top actions. After you take your top action, and after you resolve any combat or any encounters, you then, if you can, take the bottom action. The bottom actions are more expensive, and they require you to pay a bunch of these resources. They're all singles, so this would be three oil, or four ore, three wood, three food or grain, and you would get this bottom action for that. Part of what you're trying to do is figure out a way to get the best of both actions on your turn, if you can, because the blue players move gain. Now let's do this one. The blue players produce bottom action would be three oil to upgrade. My produce bottom action is three ore to deploy. So that's where there are different mixy matches. We all have upgrade, deploy, build, and enlist, but in different combinations and at different costs. In this case, if the blue player had three oil, they would upgrade. You're going to upgrade and then gain two coins. The rules suggest take your money first because you tend to forget it as the game gets thicker and you are trying to figure out what to do. And then you're like, did I take my coins or did I not take my coins? So you would pay three oil and you would then get two coins and an upgrade. An upgrade means moving any of the six cubes, on the top to one of the empty spaces on the bottom. It does not have to be the space from the upgrade section, and it does not have to go to the upgrade section. So I could, for example, move this move gain cube. Now when I take this action, I can move three units one space, and I could move that here, and that would allow me, or I guess technically here, doesn't really matter, and that would allow me to pay one fewer wood whenever I wanted to build. So that's what upgrade does. Deploy, pay the cost, and you can bring a mech onto the board. This is how you get them onto the board. They go on any space on the board where there is a worker of yours. Okay? In build, you pay whatever the building cost is. And again, build will always be wood. It'll just be different numbers for each of us. And you put a building where any space you have a worker. Let's talk about the buildings since I just got there. There are four buildings. They're up here. All right, and they each have stuff underneath them as well. The mine is the easiest to understand. When you build a mine, it is a private tunnel for yourself. It is a tunnel that you are allowed to use and essentially jump to the other tunnel spaces or from the other tunnel spaces back to your space. All right, a building once built can never be removed or destroyed. It's just always going to be there for the rest of the game. The monument, when you build, just means that anytime you take the bolster action, which I didn't explain, did I? I didn't explain that. I think I skipped that one. The bolster action is you pay a coin and you move up to strength or
power,
thank you, or you take a combat card. And if you had built the monument, then the bolster action is you move up to power or take a combat card and gain a popularity. That's what the monument does. The armory, like it sounds, gives you a power every time you take the trade action. And the mill. The mill is a building that essentially acts like a worker for purposes of production. If I were to build the mill here and then later choose the produce action, let's assume this worker here is matches. Let's assume this mill is my color. So I would produce this, I would produce on these two hexes, and then, and let's say I would choose this one and choose this one, and then additionally, now that this is uncovered, the hex with the mill on it also produces as like a free extra bonus production. So in this case, I would get a food and I would produce another worker, and this hex with the mill would produce two wood, one for this worker and one for the mill itself. All right. If I didn't have a worker there and I did the same thing, this would still produce one wood, and that wood would go here in this hex. Now, the caveat to that is, remember, when you have a building in a space and there's no one else in that space, that's when you have control of that building. But if Aaron were in this building, my mill can now not produce for me when I take the produce action, because I don't control the space. You can never produce on a space you don't control. Further, if I did produce there and I got a wood in that space, there's nothing to stop Aaron on his turn from moving into there, and now that wood is his to spend if he wants to spend it, because nothing is defending that space. And the same holds true if there were a worker in there. Aaron would come in, this worker would flee and run away, Aaron would lose a popularity, and then he would now be able to spend this wood if he wanted to. All right, that is the mill. I don't know if I said this, but only one building per hex in the game. So once someone builds a building in one of these hexes, that's it for that hex. If Aaron builds his monument here, then I can't build my mill here as well. The mill is a worker for production on any space. If your mill were here, for example, it would produce another guy for you just as if. And it produces, obviously, the mill produces on the hex that it's on.
Yep.
It's not a choice. Last but not least is enlist. Enlist is you are enlisting these four pieces. They are called, I think, your recruits. And they move from their space down here to one of these four spaces on your faction map. All right? These, when you pull, again, same thing for enlist. When you choose this action to enlist, you can enlist any of these four. It doesn't have to be the one in this space, obviously. And you take it, let's say I take this one, and I cover one of these things, and I immediately get this. So it's a one-time immediate get, two power, two combat cards, two personality,
popularity,
and two coins. All right. Additionally, I uncover this little thing. Now, let's talk about what this thing is. This exposed little circle here is an ongoing action. And the way it works is that for the rest of the game, whenever I deploy...
Meaning the bottom action.
Correct. Whenever I deploy, it's basically like, you know how if blue player builds, they get three coins?
Yeah.
So now when I deploy and I also get a coin. But I also get a coin when the players on either side of me deploy. So if Nikki deploys, I get a coin, and if Aaron deploys, I get a coin. And same thing for the other ones. You can either get a coin or a power or a popularity or a combat card. Now, I haven't talked about how the game ends. There are things that we're going to do during the game that are going to get us stars. And there's a little chart up there. When you earn a star, you take one of your stars and you put it in the little thing. Let's start from the far right, because that's easiest. This is, if you reach 16 on the power chart, you immediately get a star, regardless of whether you then drop back down. Mm-hmm. We haven't talked about combat yet, we'll get to there. If you get to the top of the popularity chart, you get a star. The next two spaces are if you win a combat, so you can get up to two stars. You win a combat, you place a star. You win a combat, you place a star. That is if you complete one of your encounters. I'm sorry, one of your objectives. Yeah. We all have two objectives, and you can only do one of them. The reason you get two is just so you have some options as to which one you can do or not do. That is if you get all of your all eight of your workers onto the board. That is if you get all of these recruits up here. If you build all four of your buildings, that is if you build all four of your, you deploy, sorry, all four of your mechs, and that is if you get all six of your upgrades from the top to the bottom. You won't do all of those because as soon as someone collects their sixth star, that triggers, that ends the game immediately. And that's what I wanted to say as far as this. Let's say this is a popularity and it gets Nikki to the top of the chart when I build. Let's say she had that on her mat. The order would be me, then her, then you, if each of you got something for me.
Oh, right.
And if her doing that off of my turn got her to the top of the chart, then that would end the game.
If it was her sixth thing.
If it was her sixth star. Yeah.
So right. I don't get mine if she gets
that. Correct.
And you, do you finish your turn?
That was my turn, right? My turn is I build.
Unless his turn ended this
Remember,
with the
when
sixth.
Remember, when you're building, that is your turn.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
So if he built his sixth mech in that case, and that was his, I mean, his fourth mech, and it was his sixth star,
then
that
would be,
and Nikki
hers.
Would not get her thing.
Right.
And the reason that that's important is that the sixth star just ends the game, but it doesn't win the game necessarily, because the winner of the game is whoever has the most money. And at the end of the game, you will have coins, and you will convert the following three things to coins. Every star you have is worth either 3, 4, or 5 coins, depending on where you are on the popularity track. Every 2 resources is worth 1, 2, or 3 coins rounded against you. And every hex on the board that you control is worth 2, 3, or 4. Let's talk about what constitutes controlling a hex. Any hex that has any of your units in it is a space you control. And any hex that has a building of yours in it and no other people is a hex you control. Also, for purposes of counting the spaces, the factory space in the middle of the board counts, factory space, thank you, in the middle of the board, counts as 3 hexes that you control. This means that if I have a monument here and Aaron, you move into that space, you now control that space, mm-hmm. and I do not. But this is just a building, it's not a unit, it's friendly, there is no combat or fighting to happen here. And since I mentioned combat, let's talk about combat. Combat works as follows. Let's say the board looks like this right now, all right? You could not move into here, and I could not move into there, because workers cannot engage in combat. They can be part of a combat, they can't, but I'll explain in a second. The workers cannot engage in a combat. They are too scared to fight, all right? The easiest way to think about it is that only your plastic pieces engage in combat. Your wooden pieces do not.
Okay.
If this were the situation, and Aaron moved his mech into this space, then my workers, who are scaredy cats, would run away. They would flee back to the home base, and for each one that left, in this case 2, Aaron would drop 1 popularity.
Oops, wrong ones. There we go.
This is not considered a combat for purposes of gaining a star.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But you could do that. Additionally, you could, if this were the situation, you could come in with this worker. That is a way that a worker can go into another space, and then I would flee. And now you would have this here. If there were some wood here, it would stay on the board. Aaron would come in here, I would run away. Aaron would drop 2 in popularity, and now
it's mine.
It's technically you can spend it if it's still there on your turn, and you still control the space on your turn.
Or you can move it out.
I can move it out, but that.
Or if you had a move, if you had another, well, you couldn't
you have
another
move
because your move ends.
But I could move it away from there before you got back.
And remember, you would do all of your movement first before the combat even happened. All right, but if we all come in here, if I have a piece of plastic myself, then we initiate an actual combat. And the way that works is we each have this little combat dial thing, and we're going to spin it to a number between 0 through 7 to spend whatever power we have. Note, I have 5 and you have 3. So the most I can spend is 5. But also, if I had 12, the most I could spend is 7. That's the only thing that's on the dial. So we're going to secretly choose one of these numbers. And then we may add, if we want, a combat card for every piece of plastic we essentially have, a character or a mech in that space.
So in this case, you could add up to 2 cards.
Up to 2 cards if you wanted to. And if you move your hand for a second, the combat cards range from 2 to 5, and it gives you the distribution in the deck. Obviously, there are more 2s than 3s, and more 3s than 4s, and more 4s than 5s. When you, here, hand me a combat card, because I don't have any.
Yeah.
When you play a combat card, you can either play it face down right here, as a bluff, essentially, I'm not really playing it. I'm just making you think I'm playing it.
Right.
Or you can play it face up. Ooh, a 4. Or you can place it face up, and that's adding to whatever your strength number is. And then, highest strength wins the combat. The tie goes to the attacker. And in this case, if you had a higher number than me, then all of my pieces would go back to the thing, back to my home base. You would lose a popularity for every worker that I had in that space that came back. You would gain a star if you had an empty space on the star track for winning a combat. And I would get a consolation, but only if I spent at least 1 power.
So if either I spent on a card or
either on, as long yes, as long as my combat number is more than 0, I would get a combat card as a consolation. And then you would be in the space. And if this space, if there was, let's say, if I had a mech here and you came in with your mech and your character and you beat me, you would then get this encounter in this space because your character is in the space with the encounter.
And your character was not, just your mech, okay.
Just right. Only characters can trigger the encounter.
If I lose that combat, I just go back to the space I entered from?
All right, so if you attack and lose, all of your pieces would retreat.
Do you lose popularity for my worker?
I do not.
Okay.
That's the one difference. I would gain the star for winning the battle. And you would gain the consolation combat card if you committed at least 1 power to the fight. But these pieces would all,
go back here.
Back to here.
Okay.
Here's a rule that we're probably not going to take advantage of, I suspect. You are allowed during the game to form alliances and make bribes.
Ooh.
None of that is enforceable. So you can completely renege on a deal you made with someone. The restrictions of these alliances or bribes, you cannot trade resources in any way. You can trade coins if you'd like. So you can pay someone, or I'll give you 2 coins. You can make things like, hey, if you don't hit me here, I won't hit you there, or I want to move there, or I'll move out of the factory if you move. Again, I can't imagine that would happen. There seems like there's already so much going on in this game. And the other part to that is that you cannot do that you can't talk your way out of combat once a combat has started. If a person moves into another space with another person, then that
negotiations are over.
Yes, then the conflict must be resolved.
Got it.
Okay.
Cool.
2 more things before we start. I never explained what this was. It's an endgame bonus card. There are a bunch of them, and in fact, we just put this one out for display. So let's get rid of it and take one off the top. That'll be this. So this is going to be our special endgame bonus. And this bonus is any of your buildings adjacency to tunnels. And the more tunnels you are adjacent to, the more coins you will score at the end of the game. 2 things. If you build a building here, then of course right now I am adjacent to these 2 tunnels. And if I were to build this building, I am now adjacent to 3 tunnels. You don't double count this one. Also, your mine does not count as a tunnel for purposes of adjacency endgame bonus scoring.
Okay.
That's the first thing. And the second thing is, now that we all know the rules, each of our factions actually has a slightly special rule-breaky power. I, as Crimea, for example, have the power of coercion, which is once per turn, I can use a combat card as a resource. Whenever I need to spend a resource for something, I can, instead of spending all resources, I can use 1 card as essentially a wild card resource.
Okay.
Nikki, what is yours?
I dominate. Weehee. There's no limit to the numbers of stars you can place from completing objectives and winning combat.
So we can only get 2 stars max from combat, but you can just keep generating those stars the whole game.
Plus and I can also do both of my
objective
cards.
Nice.
And get a star for each.
My special power here for the Republic of Polonia is I can, when we pick up an encounter card, I can choose 2 of the options on that card.
Okay, of the 3.
Yep.
All right, that's cool.
Cool. My Rus-Viet Union is relentless, and I can choose the same section on my player mat as the previous turn. So I can just do the same action over and over if I feel like it without having to move to a new section.
You are not required, like the rest of us, to move to a new section of the mat.
Right.
All right. I believe I am the star player, since I have the number 1 mat. And I don't start with combat cards to use as resources, which is on purpose. So I will produce on my very first action. And I pay nothing for that because of the workers. And I get some food, and I generate a worker. And I cannot do the bottom part, so I am done.
Fantastic. I'm producing too. So these are my 2. So I get an ore and oil, please. And that is it for me.
So I'm going to trade. I pay a coin, and I get 2 goods. I'd like 2 wood.
2 wood.
I would like 2 wood.
And they go on one of those spaces. I will produce as well, and it costs me nothing, and I produce a worker and ore.
Or what?
I was waiting for that. I was waiting for that. I don't do anything else. Your turn, Dave.
Okay. I will move this worker here, and I will move my character to this space. End of turn.
Okay. Can I choose move and not move?
Yes.
So I can do...
Yes.
It's an upgrade part?
Yes.
Yeah, you're not ready for upgrade,
it's an excellent question.
No, I'm not, but...
At any point when you take any of these actions, you can always do lesser than the action allows you to do. Okay. You can always just take part of your action.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
All right. I'm not quite ready yet now that I see the resources I need, but I wanted to know that. So I'm going to trade.
Okie doke.
I would like...
You got to pay.
Spend a coin.
To spend it. I would like to spend a coin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And what would you like?
And I would like...
To go to Z Hotel.
Can I get 2 ores, please? Or no, an ore and an oil. What am I talking about?
Metal and oil.
Well, I'm giving you an opportunity for your fabulous ore joke.
Wow, that's an interesting use of the word fabulous.
She likes my ore joke, man.
I'm
my
done.
Ore pun.
I cannot do the bottom half of my...
I will produce.
Okay.
So that gives me a food and a wood, please.
Oh, are you getting that now?
Food wood?
I'll be the resource master.
All right, resource master.
Done?
Yep, I am done.
I will use my special ability to produce 2 turns in a row. I will produce 2 workers, uncovering this, which means cost me a power to produce from now on.
Yep.
And an ore.
All right.
And I can't do the bottom. I'm going to start saying metal, just so I don't hear that joke anymore.
I am also going to produce, and that gets me 2 of these foodstuff items and 1 of these workers, which means now I have to also spend a power to produce.
Nikki?
Sorry, I was reading my special things. Okay, now I'm going to the move action, but I'm not going to take it. I would like to upgrade, however. I'm going to
Hang on. If you are not going to move your workers,
right,
you should probably at least move your character out, because you can, right?
Yeah.
Get closer to the stuff.
So that's 2.
Well, you only get to move
1.
But you might as well do it if you're
going
to do it.
Well, let's start going this way.
All right. There you go. So you use 1 of your move actions. You don't use the other.
So, but why would you not want to use your move? What's the reason for that?
Because
she wants to be producing
those.
Because
I want to be
producing
these.
She wants to use those goods.
Things.
What about just moving this dude out here?
I can't move the same thing.
The other dude.
Twice.
Your worker. You see what I'm saying? Because then you could produce more people if you go out there on the next produce.
That's true. I'm going to need more people.
And then that lets, it's still in your control, so you can use that if you're going to spend that.
I am going to spend it. Okay? Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you used two moves.
Yes, I moved this guy. And
the bottom is?
The bottom is pay two oil to upgrade.
Upgrade.
I'm going to upgrade my movement to three.
Okay.
And I'm going to downgrade the cost. Reduce the cost of my mechs.
Okay, cool.
To three instead of four. When I up...
You get a coin.
Great, I get a coin.
Yeah, you should always take that.
Let's try to remember we take that first.
Right.
Okay.
As the rules suggest.
And I am done.
Stick a fork in you, you're done.
Yeah, I'm done.
So I'm movings. I'm going to move this guy here, move this guy here, and then I'm going to pay three wood, get two coins, and build my... mines.
There you go.
Wow.
And look at that. It's already next to two tunnels.
Wow. He's winning.
I didn't explain this when this card came up, but the rivers do not cancel out adjacency for purposes of this score.
Yeah.
It's not entirely obvious, but it seems mostly obvious.
I feel like there's no reason they would, but okay.
And I'm done.
I will move as well. I'm going to move two workers here to there. That's my two moves. And I cannot yet... do any upgrades, so I'm done.
Okay. I am going to trade. I spend a coin for food and an oil. And then I am going to spend four food to enlist. And what do you need? You need these for your mechs, is that correct?
Everyone needs those for their mechs.
Ah, of course, that makes complete sense.
That mechs create complete sense?
Are you going to do that or the upgrade?
It's going to be bad.
I think I'm going to do the mechs one. And I am going to take two coins, actually, for that.
For a fountain?
No, just for my move. All right. That's my turn.
What do I want to do? I am going to produce.
Okie doke.
So, I am going to get a dude and a metal.
There you go.
And that's it.
Okie doke.
Cannot do anything else. Yes.
Okay. Let's see. move. I'm going to produce. So... I can produce on two hexes, and those will be... What do I need food for? Oh, that's enlist. It would be nice, too. So I'm going to do a person, a worker, and a wood. One wood. Thank you.
One wood what?
Wood!
Wood, wood. I would what? And that is it.
I am going to move again. One worker here and one worker here, and I'm done.
Okie doke. I am going to move. I'm going to move one worker here and my character here.
Oh.
And have an encounter.
Oh.
All right. Here we go. Here's the exciting art to my account. I guess it doesn't matter if you see the body.
No, it's not secret.
Yeah, I don't understand. That was what Aldi had us do, which is silly. You're going to explain them anyway.
You're going to explain it anyways.
There's no secret. It'd be nice if this had like a little title flavor text thing. All right, here are the three things I can do. I can clean uprooted trees after the battle is over and gain a wood and a popularity. I can throw down your bags and rush into battle and pay $2 to gain 3 popularity. Or I can study the battlefield from afar, plotting your opponent's demise. I can pay 2 popularity to look at any one opponent's combat card, then draw 3 combat card.
Wow.
Met card.
I don't know that I want to spend. Wow. Well, I can't lie to you. I was hoping to get resources. I mean, combat cards for me are resources, but...
they're wild
resources. Yeah, 3 wild cards. But he's paying popularity for that. That's pretty steep.
Gain 2 wood and a popularity.
Oh.
Boy, that seems probably the way to go.
That's resources.
Yep.
It is.
It's not the ones I want yet, but 2... Or three pop. All right, I'll do that. I'll do the free one. I'm going to gain two wood and one popularity.
And it goes on the encounter space, yes?
Yes, everything that happens in the encounter has to go in the space where the encounter happens.
And someone give Dave yellow popularity.
Yellow one, pop.
One, please.
All right. Aw, I'm the least popular.
That is my... And,
just for a little while.
I moved. And, oh, I could build right now. But that would, if I had a combat card. All right, done.
If you had wood. Okay.
I do?
He doesn't have enough.
Would I lie to you?
La, 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 la. Bam. Trade. Can I get two ores, please?
Or what?
Or else.
How do you like that? Wait, why do you get two?
Can I get one?
You can have one. And do you want to produce
any... I do not,
any,
actually.
Peoples? Meeples? No?
Nope.
Okay. You don't want to produce it?
I do not. And then I'm going to turn in three and build my first mech.
Okay.
You sure you don't want to... You might as well wait...
I'm going to uncover my Riverwalk ability.
Yep.
That goes to wood areas or areas.
Or metal.
Or metal areas. Okay. So those are the terrains that you can enter.
Yes. Yeah. And I got that and then done.
Not entirely done. I get a coin.
Oh, did you do that already?
Yeah, he did that quickly.
Done.
All right.
Thanks for giving Dave that coin.
Well, I didn't. Sorry.
Well, it was that or the upgrade one. You guys were giving me something.
Yeah.
Okay, so I can... I think I'm going to trade again? That was what I was going to do all that time ago. So I'm going to take two wood. And that is that. Let me double check that I can't do... Yeah, I don't have oil. Anywhere near me.
I'm going to produce, and I now produce two ore and three oil from my tundra fields. Yeah. And that's it. I can't afford the other thing.
However, that costs you power.
Yes, it does. Thank you, Dave.
Why is that?
Because
I've uncovered three worker spaces.
Oh, here he goes. Worker crazy.
I also will spend a power to produce. And I'm going to produce three food here.
Three food.
And a worker here. Done.
Nikki P.
Okay, I'm moving. Oops. And I get three movement. So, first of all, this dude's going to ride the mech, and we're going to go across the water. That's one, correct?
You can't go to that space across the water.
Oh, yeah, your Riverwalk only goes to woods.
Wood and...
I want it to work the way I want it.
I know, but I'm telling you how Scythe works.
That's one.
Okay, so there's one.
Yep.
And then I'm going to move my...
You can move your worker.
You've already moved the mech.
The mech's already moved, but the worker can move.
Two.
Okay.
Three.
Okay.
Ooh, three. She said three. And she gets an encounter.
Oh, I get an encounter.
Yep.
Take that off. Beautiful artwork.
Ooh. You don't have to hide the text.
Humbly take orders from your superior officer. Gain one combat card and one popularity. give a villager a ride home on your horse. Pay two to gain four wood.
Pay two what?
Two money.
Money.
Could be popularity.
Yeah, it's true.
It's money. Power.
This one's great.
Okay.
Threaten to create an avalanche with your bazooka. Pay only two popularity, to enlist one recruit.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Ooh, a recruit.
That's not bad, yeah.
Pay two popularity. I'm okay on the popularity. Pay two for wood. What does wood get me? Wood gets me buildings. I think I'm... I think I'm going to threaten to cause an avalanche.
Yeah! Wow.
So I pay two popularity.
Yep.
One,
makes sense.
Two.
And which recruit would you like?
And... That's these, right?
Yep.
That's cards, love, money... Oh, I think Which if I do that, I'll gain back my hearts right away. And plus one.
And where do you want to put it? You could put it in any of those four circles.
Okay.
And gain either two power, two coins.
No, forget it.
Okay.
I don't need people to like me.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to do it on, what is that, the combat track.
Yep.
And I'm also going to give myself two.
Okay, there you go.
So when anybody upgrades, you get that? Is that what the deal
just
is?
Just you or me upgrade, not Aaron.
Right. Yeah.
Correct.
That's true.
Good question,
and
though.
Also, you moved. Can you do the bottom ability on that?
Yeah. Pay oil, no.
Okay,
I'm going to move as well. I'm going to use my new tunnel to... the tunnel, the mind of the tunnel.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm going to move that guy. My character dude. And I'm going to build. So I will build a mill here. Cost me 3 wood. And
did you get coins
get
for
two
that?
Coins. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Don't forget the
was
coins.
Just getting
don't
that
forget
to that.
The coins.
And that is that.
I'm going to be like almost everybody else and move. I'm going to move my character one space and not take a second move, but I will take a coin for my upgrade, which costs me 2 oil.
Oil.
And I will upgrade my produce or my move. Or that one. I'm gonna upgrade my bolster cube down here to mix. Done.
Okie doke. I'm gonna spend a coin to trade. And I'm gonna take food and an oil. And I will then spend these for food to enlist again, and I will take this one off the track here, and I will put it on the 2 combat cards, please. Done.
You upgraded?
No, I did not upgrade.
Enlisted.
I enlisted.
Enlisted. Okay, you're done?
Yes.
Trade. I want to trade. Or bolster.
Or produce.
But not move.
I know. Trade. So I would like a metal and a...
Cost a coin.
And a food. For that guy.
And where are they going?
The food goes here.
No, they both go in the same space because you traded.
Okay.
Probably safe.
Okay. You done, Nick?
No other action.
Yeah, I can't do the other action.
I'm going to produce. So I will choose these two. So I get a person, which costs me nothing yet, and a metal for that one, and I get 2 wood for that.
Yeah. Ooh,
for the mill.
Milling.
Nicely done.
Milling about. Hey, did you leave a resource that's totally like out there in the middle of nowhere?
It won't be, but yes.
I know. But right now it's free.
Yeah.
You're done. No secondary.
No,
action.
I'm not. It was.
When
produce,
did that
which
happen?
Have food.
How did that resource get?
I moved
there?
This person.
He must
away.
Have moved the guy out.
Remember,
there.
He can carry that resource.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
Did you want to leave it there?
Yeah.
Take it with you. Take it with you. I mean, unless you're leaving it for a reason.
No, there's no reason because it should be near people. But I wasn't going to spend it for a while.
Yeah, I understand.
That was what I knew.
Done or no bottom action?
Yeah, I can't do the bottom.
Okay. I'm going to bolster. Since I've just upgraded that action, I pay the coin. And I get 3 power, please, for red.
Okay.
And I will build a mech, which
Why
costs
are you
me
sitting next to me?
3.
You will deploy a mech.
I will deploy a mech. Do you get
a
hand for deploy?
I do.
You're welcome, Dave. I will deploy my township mech, which allows my mechs and character to move between the villages I control and the factory.
Okay, now let me clarify that.
Yes.
That means for purposes of movement, you can move from any village to the factory, and from any factory to a village, and from any village to a village. Okay?
Oh.
It's not completely clear about how that's written on the mat, but in the rules, it just means that villages and factories are adjacent for you.
Oh, neat. So it's kind of like the mine does for us with the to the tunnels.
Just letting you know that.
I will...
Oh, and don't forget to take your 3 coins.
Oh, thanks, Dave. And I'm done.
It's easy to forget.
It really is.
It's really weird how easy it is to forget. What did I do last time? Oh, I traded. I am going to bolster. And I am going to take 2 strength. And then I'm going to spend these 2 oil and this card to upgrade. You get something for that, right?
Yes, I do.
You are
strength. Black.
You get a strength. Do you get anything for that?
No, I have no enlists.
And I am going to take the card one, I think.
The Cathcart Towers Hotel.
And I'm going to put it over here. And that is my turn.
Okay. I am moving again. I would like to know if there's any kind of an upgrade I can do so I can move one thing more than one space every time I take a movement thing.
There's the speed
for the adds
plus
and
one
your
to
character.
Oh. Or
and
she
then,
could get
and
a
then
factory
all the
card.
Factory cards have a you move one item thing two times. Spaces on the bottom of it.
Okay. Is this dude stuck? Did he have to ride a mech?
He has
no.
He has the same river walk power.
He has the same river walk
power. Yeah, only.
Okay. So he's gone one.
Okay.
And then 2.
Okay.
He's going to stay.
All right, because you have one more
she
movement.
She has a third
I
movement,
have a third
yes.
movement. I might have, that may not have been the best.
It seems like it's a pretty good one no matter
choice.
What.
Well, what if you produced first instead of that?
Let's go back there.
Okay, if you're going to do that, go ahead, do that.
What are you doing?
If you're going to do that,
you might as well
take
your stuff
resources
take it
with you.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
He's leaning aside.
He's like, he's kicking his foot up on that bag of food.
He just had cool. to carry it all over.
I know.
He's like resting. It's his resting position.
And I cannot do the second half. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to
do it.
Gonna run it again. Okay, I'm gonna. I think I'm moving. So I will move this guy, my character, and I will move this here. Okay.
Produce 2 ore.
Cost of power.
And 3 oil. Thank you. It does cost me a power. I don't know why I keep trying to skip that. And I can't enlist, so I am done.
I am going to move. Move this one here and this one here. And am I building? That is the question. Huh. I feel like I should, because I have this wood and this card. So let me do that. I'm going to spend this card and this wood, and I will build my mine here.
You done?
He built?
Yeah.
Did anybody
you
have?
Get any, oh, no, you don't get any coins for building, Dave? You do get a coin for building.
Thank you.
It's upgrading for me.
Oh, you know what? I didn't take the 3 coins for frickin' upgrading before. I get a coin for building.
Too late. No, so. All right.
And I get 3 coins for the fountain. Oh, wait, there are 3s in here.
There are 3s.
Man, it's so easy to forget.
It is, yes.
It's so easy to forget. And I'm actually going to build that mine here.
Once it's built, you can't move it.
All right, done.
All right, trading again. Oil.
Okay. Cost a coin.
Cost a coin. Oil and grain.
Oil and grain. Go in a single hex. Look at that guy. He's rich.
He's tired. That's
I know.
Why he's laying.
He's guarding all that stuff.
And 2. That's it.
I'm going to produce, so it's going to cost me a
power.
And I get to produce here, so 2 wood. okay. for that. That's automatic. And I'm going to choose metal
mm-hmm.
and peoples. Soylent Green.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And that is it because I don't have enough food for the
Got it.
Enlist.
Dave, I have a movement action question.
Okay.
Since I can move between my village and the factory, if I move my character to the factory right now, do I get my factory card immediately, or do I finish the move action?
Movement. You always have to finish all your movement. Then if there's combat, then that gets resolved. Then everything else.
Encounters or
right.
that.
So the factory is, in its way, in its sense, its own kind of special encounter, right?
Makes sense. No, keep that. That will be the first half of my move action.
Okay.
And my other move will be this mech carrying two workers back there.
Okay.
So I get now I get my factory cards?
Yes. You look at five.
I look
and you
at
draw
five
one.
And I choose one.
I did everything in the wrong order.
That's totally what this whole game is about, right? I needed to do this before I did this. Oh, those are both pretty good.
Wow.
Wow. Okay. All right. So as the after move action, I have taken my factory card.
Okay.
It allows me to pay a popularity
yep.
to either deploy a mech or build a building.
That's neat.
Yeah.
Wow.
Where a worker is. Yeah, it seems pretty good.
If you have a popularity, right? If you're down to zero,
correct.
You can't
use I am the low popularity Rusvietz. And I do have enough oil to do my upgrade action now, which I will take a coin for and pay my two
ones.
Oil. No, I just
Dave's got
I just made some
there
choice.
There are threes. These There's, are actually threes.
Yeah.
But I'll put some back if you want.
I got my coin. I will upgrade move or produce. I'm going to upgrade produce down here to buildings.
All right, here we go.
Thank you, Dunn.
I'm going to spend a power.
You don't get anything when I upgrade,
nope.
do you?
Okay. I'm going to spend a Do you? And Lincoln
no,
did.
He hasn't done
that. I'm going to spend a power to produce, because that's the power of production. And I'm going to do three of these foodstuffs, and two of these metals. And them's my turn.
Them's your turns?
All you can do?
Them's the things.
That's all I can do, because I spent my card to build this mine, when I probably shouldn't have.
All right. Moving. So, here we go. One, two, three. And that is it.
I'm going to move. So I will move this guy here and this guy here. And I have an encounter. Wait, I'm moving, so I'll build. I'll take that. Three wood to build a monument here, I guess. And that is that. I get two coins. Let me just do this. And I get an encounter card, please. Thank you. Ooh, beautiful mech. It looks like it's one of Nikki's mechs
Ooh,
in the forest,
yeah.
too. Okay. Conceive a plan with the patrolling troops in the forest. Gain one combat card and gain one popularity. Release the soldiers of some dead weight. Pay $2 to gain any three resources. Ooh. And then deceive the soldiers and steal their mech. So pay three popularity, which I cannot do. Oh, no, I can. Ooh.
Harsh, though.
So I'm going to do that. Boom. And I'm going to pay $2 to gain any three resources. So that's because my power, I can do two of them.
Yep.
So you did the first two?
Yep, okay. The second two.
The second two.
Yeah, the expensive ones.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to do, let's see here, Riverwalk lets me do, but he got good stuff out of it.
Yeah.
I'm going to do that.
My encounter was.
Oh, it's here, where the encounter was.
Right.
That's and I also, what was the resource? I get three resources. So
yeah.
I want a metal. Actually, wait. I already built the mech. So I want three food.
Three food.
Yeah, I never get to. It's hard to do that with this. It's. Yep. I need to.
Got it. It should go on the encounter space.
That's true. Yep. Putting it with my other food where I plan to spend it.
I understand. It doesn't really matter, like, if you spend it next turn, but.
And I built, that. So I get. Oh, and that chip's gone.
Okay. Yeah, just...
Ah, yes. Now, if that was so much stuff, I don't know what I'm doing now. I think I'm bolstering. I'm going to bolster 3 power, please, for red. Cost me the coin. But I will also then deploy another mech.
That gets me a coin.
It gets me 3 for a deploy. And I will deploy my speed mech here.
Okay.
Done.
I'm going to trade. Cost a coin. And I am going to take 2, 4. Is that what I'm going to do? Me 2 oil. I'm about to do this. Huh. Upgrade or not upgrade? That's the rub. Yes?
You changing out
mech? I might change which mech it was, just if I can think about it for a second, but I can think quietly while Dave takes his turn.
It's okay. I'll take an oil and a metal. MN. I'm going to keep going?
Yeah, I'm okay.
And then I will spend 3 food to enlist. That gets me a combat card. And I will enlist the... You have no wood. You have no wood. I will enlist this upgrade-y one, and I will take 2 strength.
Do I get a thing when you do that?
I just enlisted.
Okay. Just you chose that, but I don't get
correct.
It for that.
It's upgrade,
okay.
Yeah.
It's the action. It's the enlist action.
Yep.
Your turn, Nick P.
Okay. We're trading again. I would like...
To go to Z Hotel?
An ore and an oil, please.
Did you spend the coin?
No.
There you go.
Take a 3. Yeah.
Okay.
And I'll just. Where do you want them? Here? With all your
other
stuff?
Sure, why not? Because I'm spending these right now.
Okay.
I'm deploying a mech.
All right. That gets me a coin.
Mech. Speed. He's going to go there. And. Blah, blah, blah. Done.
I'm going to produce. So I pay a strength, power, whatever.
Okay.
And I will. Produce on oil. No, I don't have a person there. So 2 metal,
okay,
and 2 wood.
That's your mill.
Oh no, actually, let's do the food.
Okay.
And then I get 2 wood.
2 wood from the mill.
2 wood from the mill.
A mill.
Right.
And then I can finally enlist. So I will spend 3 or 4. Excuse me. And I will do the enlist option.
Okie doke.
And I would like 2 popularity.
There you go.
And I'm done. Oh, and I get 2 dollars. This is terrible.
Because you forget the money.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Enlist.
You really just need to say, I'm getting this much money for this.
Well, it's just weird because... I don't think of enlist as... I've barely ever enlisted in this game.
I know.
And so I don't think of it as a building
thing. Well, my enlist
doesn't
have money, right? That's the thing.
Okay, that may be what the deal is.
If, like, everyone got the same money for the same thing, it would be easier to remember, but it's different every time. All right, Aaron.
I'm going to use my special factory action.
Neat.
So I will pay a popularity to immediately build another mech. And it will be my Riverwalk mech. And I guess I'll put him here.
And because you took a factory action to bring that mech onto the board, that is not considered a deploy. So I don't, for example, get my ongoing coin bonus, nor would you if you would also have that revealed on your deploy.
It's only the bottom of the actual faction board that triggers those bonuses?
It's easier to think of it this way. That factory action is a top row action.
Oh, okay.
It is, isn't it?
Yes. It is.
Mm-hmm. And you basically only get these from your bottom row action, from yours or other players' bottom row actions. Okay.
Understood.
So you still have your move.
I still have my move, which is a single thing, two spaces.
Up to two spaces, right?
Correct.
You don't have to take the
right, I don't actually. But I believe I will.
Oh, and where are you river walking if you want to? Where can you go?
I can go to yellow and red, farms and villages.
Okay.
Speaking of which, I believe I will go 1, 2 for my river walk. Move to a village.
Okay. And that is your turn.
Done.
I am going to spend a power and produce. And I will get 3 food. And 2 ore or metal. And I will spend 3 of those metal to deploy my +2 speed mech here. And I have the bonus, so that gets me a coin. And no bonus. No. End of turn.
All right. Moving. I am moving this guy two. 1, 2.
How can you move him two?
I've got...
Oh, okay, yeah.
Speed?
Speed. I got speed.
Which guy? This guy right here?
I moved him. 1, 2.
Yep.
Okay.
And then here's 1.
Okie doke.
And then this mech's going to go here.
Okie doke.
So now...
Now it's combat. Now, before that happens, yes. Just let me ask, did you want to leave this worker here?
Yes.
Okay.
Do I do the second half, or no. Do we do the combat?
Combat gets resolved first.
Oof.
All right, I got 2 things in there.
No, it's just remembering to do the other half.
Oh, yeah. You remember.
Okay.
All right, so
okay.
Aaron has 7 that he can spend. You have up to 4 that you can spend. Aaron can add a combat card. You can add up to 2 combat cards.
Okay.
You didn't unlock your other stuff yet.
And...
You're like evil.
How many cards by 2? How many cards do you have? 2?
She has
only
2.
Only 2.
Good to know. Thank you.
Only, I like that. Only 2.
Wait. I should have 4 though.
How come?
Oh, yeah. She should have started with 4.
Yeah, I should have started
with
4.
Quite a bit.
Well, I'm
did you not have any
sorry.
To start with?
No,
she had 2.
I only had 2.
Oh, wow.
She starts with 4.
I start with 4. It was just a miss.
Whose fault is that?
Probably her own.
Probably my own.
Well, luckily we corrected it before it mattered.
I was like, wait a second, I think my guy starts out pretty
buff.
It actually matters a lot to me because now I know she has a much better chance of having good cards.
Hold on. I gotta bluff you.
Holding.
Bluffing. Of course, you're probably doing a better job at bluffing than me. Okay.
All right, we ready? All right, let's reveal. All right, Nikki has spent 3 of her power. Aaron has spent...
I got 1.
1.
1 of his power. And Nikki added 7 more in cards, and
wow.
Aaron did not play a card.
Yeah.
So these cards go away.
What did
Star
I just say?
For Nikki, though.
Bluff.
Yeah,
Aaron,
but you...
Aaron goes back to his home base.
I don't care. I'm happy.
You also get a combat card.
Yes,
since you
my
did
consolation
spend
prize.
Something.
Star for Nikki.
Nikki, you get a star for winning the battle.
Sure.
And you get 1 of these.
Wonderful.
And still has the bottom.
Still hasn't done the bottom. Correct.
This is true. I think it's got to be this one. Okay.
Okay.
So I place that here.
Okay, let's pay 2 coins.
Pay 2 coins to gain either both.
Yep.
A mech.
And a strength. And a power.
And a power.
Yep.
Wow.
All right.
So there's that. Now,
you're still on your bottom action of your move.
Hold on. When do I do this part?
Oh, and if you fulfill an objective.
Don't they usually say end of your turn?
It doesn't. At any point, it doesn't really matter.
So I think they...
At the end of your
turn.
They
all say at the end of your turn.
Okay. We'll save that for at the end of my turn.
Okay.
2 oil...
To upgrade.
Okay.
And that is going to
be... And that gets me a strength or a power.
Bolster. And I am going to do that, how much I pay to enlist. So now I'm just 2 grain to enlist instead of 3.
Nice.
And did you take your coin for that?
Sure didn't.
Action?
Take. Yep.
Okay.
It's easy to forget.
Now.
Hey, what else?
And this.
Which
and then
objective?
There's this. My objective is machine over muscle. Have 1 factory card. Have at least 1 mech. Have at least 1 mech and no more than 3 workers.
Wow.
That is hard.
That is tough. But
she did it. Give that lady a star.
Wow. 2-star turn.
And she can do her other objective, right? That's her special power for her thing as well?
Yeah.
Wow. And that
all right, Link.
Turn.
Okay. Somehow I've got to make this work. Well, it's, right? I have an odd objective, too. It's not exactly that bad. Let me double check. Okay, that other one's really bad. Okay, what was it? Where I need to be at? It's ridiculous. So I'm gonna move, I guess. No, I'm gonna move because I'm gonna build. So I'm gonna move this guy here. Gonna move this guy here. Is that correct in my brain? Yes. And I get to build, so I'm going to build my final building, which is my armory.
Nice.
I gain 2 coins for that. Let's just do that. And
did you spend the wood yet?
No, it's right here.
Thank you.
And I get a star.
Yes,
hooray!
You do.
For the buildings, all the buildings is. And that is my turn.
Okay.
I don't actually know what I want to do for my turn. That does that.
Yep.
I'm going to... I'll produce. Spend 1 power for red. I get 2 people, which means it now costs me power and popularity to produce.
Oof.
And, you know what, I don't want to do that. Give me my power back.
You got it.
Give me my power back, Dave.
You got
Let
it,
Let me steal my power.
Got it.
I'm
He's
going to
fight the power.
I'm going to move.
Don't fight the power.
I'm going to move this mech here. It can go 2 and it can riverwalk. And I'm going to move my character here to have an encounter.
At far point,
have an encounter.
Okay.
Spend a day planting crops at a farm. Look, there's my bear pulling the plow on the farm
to conceal the stuff.
It's a well-trained bear.
To earn some goodwill. They're very well-trained. I can gain 2 food and popularity, or I can dislodge a stubborn plow and earn a favor from the farmers. Pay $2 to gain a worker and any 2 resources. Or I can salt the earth and force the farmers to enlist. Pay 2 popularity, which I don't have, to enlist a recruit. So, really, the only one that sounds good to me is the free one. So I will gain 2 food and 1 popularity for red, please. 1 popularity for red, please.
Sure.
And then the bottom half of my action is upgrade. Do you have an upgrade? You get a power for that.
Thank you.
You have upgrade.
I'm enlist.
All right. I paid my 2 oil. I get a coin, and I will upgrade my move to here. Thank you, Dunn.
All right. I'm going to trade. Cost me a coin. And these 3 food. And I will enlist my last recruit.
Ooh.
So that gets me a star. And it also, I have to put it here, gets me 2 popularity. 2 popularity for yellow, please.
I think it's the hat, the army
yeah,
hat dude.
Right.
2 popularity for yellow, please. Thank you. And a combat card. And that is my turn.
Your turn, Nikki P.
Okay. I'm going to bolster, so I pay a coin, move me up 3 on the track.
You are black. Okay.
And then I'm going to pay two to enlist.
Hooray! I get a card.
I also get a card, but Lincoln gets one first. Actually, Nikki gets one first. If she had it, she doesn't. Right. Then Lincoln.
It goes back to Lincoln? I thought it went to you
first. Nope, it goes clockwise.
First.
Nope, it goes Nikki, then Lincoln, then me.
Ooh.
So here's my two food.
Oh, yep, thank you.
And I'm enlisting a heart dude for two up the heart track. One, two, and for enlisting, I get three coins. I'll take a three. I'm done.
Okie dokie. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to bolster, pay a coin, two up on the power. I get a popularity, and I'm going to build a mech.
I was going to steal those if you left them.
And then I'm going to...
I almost did it just to do it.
Build a mech.
To do what?
Well, any of us could have just moved there on the tunnel and taken off four of that metal. That was a little risky of you.
I did think about it at one point.
It's what it was, Dave.
Yep.
And that is it. Did anybody get a deploy bonus? Aaron? No.
I don't have any of those yet.
Upgrade or build.
Okay. I guess I did say it. You guys should be on top of it. But
yeah, we should.
Yeah?
I don't know what I'm doing. It's that or that.
No, not that.
I have to do something.
Not that.
I want more there. You know what? I am going to move again, since I can do the same thing as many times as I like, pretty much. So I'm going to move. I'm going to move That'd be fun, right? I'm going to move my character.
Because you can river walk, correct?
To villages and farms.
Yeah.
And I can also move two.
Counter.
I'm going to move this mech here with a worker.
Okie doke.
And I'm going to move this mech here with a worker.
Okie doke.
I will now take my encounter. Thank you. Take that encounter token, would you, Dave?
Mm-hmm.
I'm in a big, like, steam engine, like, factory. I don't care. I don't want you to read it. It's all mine. That's a pretty cool one. I'm in, like, a locomotive factory. I can help an inventor install a heavy gear, gain two oil and one popularity. Yeah, that actually works nicely for me. I can hire the inventor and fund his crazy inventions, pay $3 to build a structure. Or steal the inventor's fuel source, pay two popularity to gain four oil. Well, I can pay for a building or I can take the oil, which is nice for the upgrade. I think I'm going to pay $3 to build a structure. I'm going to build my monument down there. And that is done with that.
You're doing all the things that would get me if you were sitting next to me.
I lie. I'm going to not build that. I'm sorry. I'll take my $3 back. Because if I take the oil right now, I can use it for the bottom half action, and I'll do that.
Okay.
I get two oil. Do I get a popularity?
Sorry. Which action did
you
take?
The very top one, I know. Two oil and a popularity. Ding, ding. Encounter is done. Spending the oil for an upgrade. Do you get something for upgrading?
I do. I get strength.
You're welcome. and I will upgrade.
I get something from all your bottom actions, man.
Well, why don't you then? I'll upgrade this to, I don't care about any of those, here, and I get a coin for that, and it's the end of my turn, on which I control at least one of each primary terrain type.
Nice.
Farm, wood, oil, village, ore.
Neat.
With at least one worker on each at the end of your turn.
That's hard.
You're kidding.
I have completed an objective. Yeah, it really makes me spread out. But I have, that is a, I've diversified production, by the way.
Okay.
What was yours called?
Mine was Machine Over Muscle.
Oh, that's cool. That's a good title.
She didn't tell us
All right,
that.
Dave, go.
All right, I'm going to move. My first move is going to be this guy and all these guys. I'm going to go 1, 2. And then for my second move, I'm going to go 1, 2. There is no combat, but I lose a popularity. This goes back to here.
Yellow.
Yep.
Right.
And then I cannot do the bottom action. I'm done.
All right. I'm moving. I'm moving this guy 2, 1, 2. This guy 1. And I don't actually want to take my third move, but I do get an encounter.
Yep. Take it.
So to pull that off. Help an anxious farmer font. Oh, I didn't show the picture.
Oh, let's see the art. Yes.
It's like a mech under construction. It's kind of neat. Help an anxious farmer find a missing part of his mech. Gain 2 coin and a popularity. Con the farmer into selling you some scrap metal under market value. Pay 2 coin to gain 4 metal. Steal a newly built mech when it's ready. Pay 3 popularity to deploy 1 mech. Okay. Ugh. But next is when you pay two to gain one. Pay 2 to gain 4 metal. This is not a good card for me, actually. Pay 3 popularity to deploy a mech. Do I really want to do that to my popularity? I don't have a lot of money coming in though fast enough, so I guess I'll pay 3 popularity and deploy a mech. So 1, 2, 3. I'm doing my before combat on a territory with a tunnel.
Yep.
Opponent gets a -2.
Yep.
And it minus two
goes there. Yep.
They go down here too. They go down 2 in your power. That's before each combat.
On a tunnel.
Yeah.
On a tunnel space. So don't leave me alone.
Don't camp on those tunnel spaces.
That was it. And the bottom half of my action I can't do.
Okay. I'm moving. 1, 2. And I'm having an encounter.
Token, please.
Yep.
Thank you.
Oh, look at the gorgeous art. There's a big bear.
Hey, nice. There's a lot of green
that's
in there.
It's my guy, too. It's a bear. See, it's totally my card.
What country is your faction from?
Polania, Poland.
Did you know they have a constitutional amendment to give them the right to arm bears?
Oh. All right, man.
Oh.
That's not very nice.
I've been waiting all game for that.
That's not fair.
Okay, whistle while you wait for the geese to cross the road. Gain $2 in 1 popularity. Pay the girl to get her pet geese, or you call them dinner. Or as you call them, dinner. Pay 2 to gain 4 food.
Wow.
Feed the geese to your animal and claim the farm as your own. Pay 2 popularity to build 1 structure. I don't need to do that. So I'm going to do gain $2, gain a popularity.
Woohoo! Hey, does that count for me in this?
No.
And then I'm going to pay $2. Oh, I'll just pay that right back and gain 4 food.
Nice.
Did you do the semi-nice mean one?
The last one didn't help him, so he did.
Well, the last
I'm
one
just
did.
Asking.
Oh, right. He didn't
steal
the farm.
The second one. Yeah, I didn't.
I keep choosing the mean ones.
Okay.
The mean ones are the best ones. They get you the most stuff.
They do.
And you have a bottom action.
No wood. Well, it said it was food, right? Yeah, I need the food more than I need the wood. I don't need to build anything anymore.
I'm going to take my factory card action and pay a popularity to deploy my final mech.
Yep.
It's not an actual deploy action for Dave's bonus, thank goodness. This mech is my People's Army technology, which allows me now to, in a combat where I have at least 1 worker, I can play an extra combat card.
Nice.
So I could play 3 combat cards on that space. I think that is maybe where I'm going to put it, actually. Sure, why not? that gives me a star for deploying my fourth mech.
Yep.
Sweet.
And it allows me... Go ahead, finish your turn.
I will.
Now you get two
moves. Now I'm so curious what it allows you to do. I get a move, which actually I can move three spaces, right? Because I have the speed technology,
I believe,
and that's
that is
a
correct.
Double move.
Yeah.
So I'm going to move my character one, two through the tunnel, three to have an encounter.
Can you cross that water?
No.
Then try it again.
I could go there. I just thought that was a good space. I will try that again.
Well, you could jump right to there, right? Because it's a village. You can do village.
No. Township is only for villages I control, which is currently only this one on the board.
Well, this one, obviously.
That's not a village. Oh, no. That's a tunnel.
Oh, you're right. So you couldn't even jump to that one.
Nope. Which means I don't think I can get to any encounters, which is kind of a bummer. But, right? I can't get to any. One, two.
I keep forgetting this is a territory here.
Yeah, I know.
It's a strange yet invisible hex, but who's going there?
I don't know. It's oil. I mean, I
if you need it.
So I won't move my character. I will move a mech because that's what I need to move, and I will move here.
Okay.
Yep, I'm done.
All right. I'm going to produce. Cost me a strength. Three would go there.
Power?
Power. Three would go there.
Where? Here?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Two of these go here. And I will spend... Let me see if I got this right. I will spend two of these and a card to deploy.
Discard.
Deploy, deploy.
Deploy now.
Okay.
No, sir.
No.
And which one do I want? The Riverwalk? Is it oil and food? No. I think I'm going to deploy this one, my scout.
What's the scout give
Before
you?
Before combat, I steal one of the opponent's combat cards at random.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, that's interesting.
And I think that's going to go here.
Are you done?
Yeah, yeah.
Did you get any coins for that?
Oh!
Thank you, I guess you're not done.
I get three. Man.
Take the three, please.
Yeah.
Here, I'll put back two and take a five.
Even better.
Done. All right, Nikki.
Yeah. I'm moving.
Thank you for the reminder.
No, I'm not moving, apparently. Yeah,
apparently you're doing anything
but
moving.
Because I'm not moving. I cannot.
Your factory card has a move on it, though, if you want to do that.
Yeah, moves two, something too.
Oh, this is what I'm going to say.
Oh, that's right.
Let me interrupt for just a second. You deployed all four of your mechs now, all right?
Oh, yeah.
You can still take the deploy action on the bottom row of your card.
Interesting.
Because you are always allowed to not take everything from your action. And the reason you might is it's worth three coins.
Right. Yeah. So I could essentially just
you can turn
metal into coins.
You can turn two metal into three coins if you want.
It's three metal into three coins right now. It starts at four for
Correct.
Me.
Correct. Okay. But that's still
that's a good
that's
point,
still a points upgrade.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Nikki.
Well, actually, it's not.
Yeah. Let's use this wonderful card I fought
it
to
is.
Get.
Three metal's only worth two. One. It's every two resources.
Not if you're up here.
Yes, that's what he said.
Every two is worth two.
Right. And three would be... Oh, I see what you're saying.
It's the same.
Go ahead, Nikki.
It's the same.
I'm going to use my wonderful card that I fought so hard to gain.
Are you going to do the top part?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
So, I pay two. Change. And I gain both. A mech and up this track.
There's the track.
And my mech is an underpass dude, and he moves between any mountain I control and any tunnel.
And that's like Aaron's. That means you can also move from any mountain to any mountain, as long as you control them both.
Okay. And this can go anywhere I have people, right?
Yes. Has
workers.
To be where there's
workers.
A worker.
Let's get him right up in there.
You get a star.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Because you have all four of your mechs on the board now.
Cool. And I'm going to do the move part of this card, too.
Okie doke.
So this guy's going to go one,
yep.
two,
That's your territory, correct?
Mountains and tundra. She can move to rivers across. Yes.
Okay.
And
yep.
The ore there.
Yep. These guys run away.
Yeah.
You lose 2 popularity.
Not there, Dave.
Oh, sorry. You lose 2 popularity.
1. Do I go into there?
You go to 0.
That is 0.
That is 0.
Oh,
zero.
No. Okay. You're fine.
All right.
Nice.
Nice steel.
Nice steel.
Metal.
And, oh. I should have spent all 3 instead of the card.
So I'm going to...
Boy, that hurt.
What?
This.
Oh, his steel.
Yeah. And the will.
Okay, I'm going to...
It's not yours anymore.
Never was to begin with. Probably should have built the mech there. Mm-hmm. But I had other plans, right?
I'm going to bolster. I'm going to pay a coin. I get 2 power, please. And I get... popularity, and I cannot build or deploy, excuse me. So, your turn.
I'm going to produce. Spend 1 power for red, please. I can produce on 3 hexes. I'm going to produce 2 food here. I'm going to produce 1 oil and either a guy or an ore. Do I need the ore for anything? I think I actually need the person here. Produce that guy. That's the end of my produce, but now I can finally enlist.
Yay, I get a card.
I spend
I get a card.
2 food, and I get 2 coins. Put in a 3 and take a 5, and I will enlist. So you guys get your thing. I think, what am I going
to do? Is it, do you first?
Me
Dave?
First, yes.
Dude, he doesn't get one, right? Because he didn't have any.
Unless he had that.
No, he did not. I did not. This is my first one. Very first one. I'm going to take 2 popularity. Whee.
You're popular.
And I'm done.
Well, I'm going to move. My first move is going to be here. 1, 2.
Factory.
My second move is going to be here. 1, 2. And then... this gets resolved before my bottom. Bottom.
Bottom.
Huh. Okay, I'm going to take this one. Let's pay 2 coins for an upgrade and a popularity. And then I will spend 3 wood.
To build.
To build.
Nikki, do you have that exposed?
I do have the building exposed, so I get a popularity.
Yes, you do.
Badly needed.
I'm going to build the monument here. Wait. I just lost steel. Do I need...
metal.
Yeah. Do I need metal is the question. That's assuming that I ever produce again, which I probably will. So I will build.
Can you take goods and exchange them for other types?
Not in any way.
They only count for points at the end of the game.
I will.
2 for 1.
I will build.
Or 2 for 2 or 2 for 3, depending on where your popularity is.
Wow.
That's my turn.
That is your turn. Nikki P.
Except I built, so I get a coin.
Nope.
Thank you.
Your turn, Nick.
It's so easy to forget.
Yeah.
Okay. Moving. Okay. 1, 2. 1. 1. Bottom half is...
Wait, you're giving... Or do you want to take those resources with
you
so you can
take
still
all
control them?
Sorry.
That seems smart.
A mech can drag them?
Yes.
Yeah. Any unit can carry
resources. Anyone can carry resources.
All right. That's 2 oil for that, and I'm done then.
I'm going to move. I'm going to move all of these guys too.
Smart.
And I'm going to... I'm going to move that guy. And that's my turn.
I'm going to produce again. It now costs me a popularity and a power.
Done.
I will produce 2 workers, gaining a star for putting all my workers on the board.
Oh, jeez.
Yep.
I will also produce two food over here, and one oil for my third hex. And I will enlist, take your bonuses for the enlist.
Card, please.
Dave first.
Not that it mattered. Lincoln clearly got the better card.
I get two coins for enlisting.
Two coins for enlisting.
That's not how it goes. And I will take two combat cards for the enlist bonus. Done.
Oh, the best ones. What am I doing? I really don't. I really don't have a thing. One, two, three. Okay, I'm going to do that. All right, here's my turn. I'm going to move. I'm going to go here to my factory.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to pay two for popularity, please. And an upgrade. And I'm going to upgrade this bolster, I guess, for this wood right here. And then I'm going to do move. I get a 2 plus 1 is 3. And I'm going to go 1, 2, 3.
You're going to have an encounter at far
point. Here comes the fight.
Oh, fight times.
Okay.
All right, so I lose 2.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
No.
Not in a tunnel, right?
Not in a tunnel. Mm-mm.
I randomly steal a card from you.
Boo, that's an evil power.
Yeah.
All right, and now we fight. Okay. 8. Ties go to me.
They do?
Yep.
Okay.
So.
That's ridiculous.
I lose this card. Would you spend 4?
4.
And I spend 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You get a card for. Okay.
Consolation.
For spending something.
Her person goes to the home base.
That goes there.
Okay.
You get a star.
Oh, you're right. And that ends my turn.
All right, I'm going to produce. I am going to produce a worker, definitely. And
put him worker goes in there.
Here. And I'm going to do green or oil. Grain. Grain, please. I guess that goes there.
Yep.
And that's my move.
Cool. I'm going to produce. It's going to cost me a strength.
Okay.
Power. Keep saying that incorrectly. I'm going to get 2 wood.
That's your free mill space.
2 food. And 2 ore or metal.
Or steel?
Yeah, it's metal, I think is what it says, even though we call it ore. Because we're all settlers at heart.
Right.
And that is... Oh. And I will food it up. So I'm going to enlist.
I get something. I get a combat card.
So I'm going to pick upgrade, and I'd like... My strength to go? I'll take 2 victory points. No, my strength to go up, too, Dave. And I get 2 gold for that as well. And a card, because I have enlist. Thank you.
I'm going to move. I'm going to move my character, can go 3, 1, 2, 3. That did not cross any rivers, since I know people would be interested.
Right.
I am going to, my second move will be this, and my third move will be tunnel there. That will start a combat.
Yep.
You have 1 card?
I have 1 card.
And it's not on a tunnel.
Correct, not on a tunnel.
And you have 1 power. And I can spend up to 3 cards, just fly.
So remember, you have to spend at least a point to get another card.
Right.
Okay.
One way or the other.
Okay.
6 from all my 3 cards, and you spent nothing. Nothing.
How many did you spend here?
0 first? From there.
Thank you.
Star.
Home base.
Yeah, I know. I was just waiting for...
That was the top half of my card. I will also upgrade. Upgrade?
Yep. Yes. Gets me a power.
Gives strength. Me a power.
Strength.
Gets me... Power,
whatever it's called, power.
That, and it gets me a coin, which I won't forget to take for upgrading.
Is that it?
That is it.
Dave, your turn.
Deuce.
Power.
Yep. I don't even get the mill action. Cause I only have 2 places I can produce. And there they are. Done.
And did.
Did and did. But I will get to build a mech. And I think I'm going to take those from here. Just in case the fight shows up. 1, 2, I guess this one. No, 1, 2, and a card. And I'm gonna build this one. This one is my Wayfarer, and it allows me to move from any territory to, or home base to, any locations, factions, home base, not in use, which in this case would be either the purple or the blue. Not...
Or this one. There's green also.
Or green, thank you. But not...
Not unoccupied, just not in use in this game.
Correct. Guess I'm going to do that here.
And what action was that? Did you... Deploy?
That was produce, and then yes, I deployed.
I will take a coin.
Hey,
thank you,
too,
Dave.
Actually. Actually, plus 2 more. God, I'm dumb. All right, Nikki.
I'm moving. Okay. 1, 1, 2.
Encounter.
Encounter.
Do you have a third move that you want to make?
I'll just move him back.
Okay.
Okay, encounter. Take the coin. Here's a picture. Offer some advice to fix a broken pulley at a defective mine. Gain 2 coin and 1 popularity. Haggle for some cheap ore from the mine's owner. Pay 2 and gain 4 metal. Cut the pulley loose without hesitation. Pay 2 popularity to build 1 structure. Okay. Structure.
You can do the mill.
Yeah, I'm thinking about the mill. I'm thinking about the first one or the last one. Pay 2 popularity.
Which you can't do.
Right, because I don't have enough popularity, so I think I have to just pay 2 to gain 1 popularity. Or pay 2 to get 4 metal, but I don't need metal really anymore except for endgame stuff. So I'm just going to pay 2 coins and gain a popularity track thing.
Okay, go up 1 for black.
1, 2.
2 for 1?
2 for 1.
Wow.
It's pretty not good. The whole card was not good for me.
That's terrible. Okay. I'm going to move. I'm going to put a dude here. I'm going to move here. And I'm going to build. Is that correct? No, I'm not going to build. And I finish this.
Objective?
Yep. It's called a wolf 16. Among the sheep. Okay. Now, control a territory with your character, exactly 1 mech, exactly 1 worker, and at least 5 resources
wow.
at the end of your turn.
Wow, tricky.
Yeah. That's hard.
Yeah.
That's why I was leaving stuff there.
That makes sense.
So I spent it so that I wouldn't get screwed, but...
What's it called just to...
It's called a Wolf Among the Sheep.
Wolf Among the Sheep.
1 star, like a...
And that's for my
objective.
And I am done.
Yeah.
I will move again.
Okay.
I will move my character here.
Encounter at fire point.
And I will move 2 mechs here.
Oh, You're mean.
I know, but it actually pays to pick on the same person again. Combat or encounter
combat
first?
Combat is first. Because if the encounter token were here, you'd have to resolve the combat first.
Right, that makes sense. I have 4 power, Nikki has 1. I can play 3 cards, she can play 1.
It's 3? Why is it 3?
Because of my worker, People's Army, the worker adds a 3rd card if I want to play it.
It's weird that that one, that's like the confusion I think that we had when we first played this
Actually,
game.
Yep. I'm going to leave the worker there, and I can only play up to 2 cards.
Kay.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Because I can still play 6 and win with 2 cards. You played nothing but 1 power, and she gets a card.
Yep.
I get a star for winning a combat. I spent these 2 cards. And now the encounter.
Yep.
Is it at far point?
it's in the snow with some kind of broken down mech.
Ah, I think I've seen that one before.
I can take photos, they're all like posing on top of it.
Yeah.
And the bear is standing next to it, that's awesome. I can take photos for the overly enthusiastic soldiers, gain 2 medal and 1 popularity. Or I can hire a mercenary to join my group, pay $3 to enlist a recruit. Or I can practice my shooting at the unsuspecting targets, pay 2 popularity to gain 4 medal. I will hire a mercenary to join my group. I will pay $3 to enlist a recruit, which gets me 2 coins back. So really that only costs me a buck.
Your turn, Dave.
And it didn't trigger anything. Done.
All right, I'm gonna use my factory. I'm gonna spend 2 to get an upgrade. I'll take this one. Wow, it does not want to come out.
Some of them are actually tight. Like Aaron's board was hard to put them in.
Yeah,
some of them, maybe the cubes are like off-sized a little.
Right, or just the holes didn't get punched. But I like them being snug.
We should talk about that at the end. No, the boards are amazing.
Yeah.
Here, sure. And then, and I gain a popularity, please.
You gain a popularity?
Yes.
Sweet.
And then for my move, I can move 1 thing 2, plus I have speed, so I'll use my ability to go 1, 2, 3, and have this encounter.
At far point?
Yes.
Yeah.
Finally an encounter. Tamper with the draft documents and keep the family together. Gain $2 in a popularity. Deliver conscription papers and payment. Pay 3 to enlist a recruit. I got all my recruits. Strong arm the family to take their farm. Pay 2 popularity to gain a worker and 3 food. So I'm going to do the free one and gain a popularity and $2.
Sweet. Popularity.
Yep.
Okay. NTP?
Wait.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, that's right. That is the end of my turn. I don't have a bottom action because I did the factory.
All right, Nikki P.
Okay, I'm going to trade.
Okay, dope.
And
cost
that
a coin.
Means I pay.
Yep.
Get what, 2 back.
What 2 things do you
I
want?
I would like some grain and I would like an oil. Oil
barrel.
All
in the same spot.
All in the same spot.
All right.
And then the bottom half is that nothing.
Okie doke.
I'm going to bolster, which I have to pay a coin. I get 2 strength. I get a popularity. And I'm going to build a mech, or deploy a mech.
That gets me a coin.
These 3 here. There you go, sir.
Oh, you're bolstering?
No, he's
no,
deploying.
Deploy. And that will give me, I'll do my submerge, and I will do it there. And I get 2 coins for that. So I'll give 1 to get 3 back.
All right, I will trade. I don't have that. I can never do that. I will just produce to end the game.
Okay.
I produce 2 food.
Boo.
I produce 1 wood and 1 oil. I will spend 2 food to enlist. Take your enlist bonuses.
Dave, you first.
Dave and
the card doesn't, cards are useless. They're
I know.
Not worth anything
got
in the game.
A whole fistful of
I also
hey,
get
I finally
a card.
Got a 5.
I get a card. And I get 2 power for my final enlist and 2 coins. 2 power, it's not going to matter, but the 2 coins do. I have done all my enlistments. That's 6 stars.
Oh, that ends the game?
Yes.
Yeah.
Cool.
I almost wanted to take one more turn to end it differently, but...
Through the upgrade?
Yeah, because the upgrade would have allowed me to move and get a bunch more points from hexes, but it's a two-turn finish
Correct.
Instead of one.
Well, I could have got a star last turn.
How so?
But I got the popularity instead, and I think that's actually...
I think that's
probably more powerful.
That might actually make it very close.
Whoa. All right, well, let's figure it out. Now we cash stuff out.
Okay.
So, let's start with you.
Sure.
You have 3 stars. Those are $3 each, so that's $9.
Okay. Give me a dollar, Nikki P.
Sure.
You control 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 territories, is that correct? At $2 a piece, so that's $10 for you.
Okay.
And you have 1, 2, 3 resources.
Yeah, that's it.
So one more dollar. And did you build any buildings?
No.
Okie doke. Lincoln.
Yep.
You control. You have 2 stars for $6.
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces you control for 10. And you have just 2 resources?
No.
No, he's got a
I can't see back there. I'm sorry.
He's got 5.
All right.
5. Those are yours.
So 2 more dollars.
Uh-huh.
And buildings.
But buildings, you are next to 1, 2, 3.
That's it.
So it's 4 more.
4 more dollars.
It's not bad, though.
No.
Aaron, you have 6 stars?
I do.
18.
He's got money over there.
Yep. 20 minus 2.
You control 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces.
Six. That's what?
12?
12.
And you have 2 resources, as far as I can see?
I have 2 up here. I have 4 resources.
Here.
2, 3, 4.
Okay.
That's it.
Two more dollars. Yep.
And I built 0 buildings.
All right. I have 2 stars at the next level for 8. So that's 10. Turn back 2. I control 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces for 12.
But you're getting paid better for all these
things. Yeah,
I am.
Yeah. I am. And then I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 resources for 4. So 5 back 1. And I am next to 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 more dollars. So throw in 1.
Take 4 or 5, yeah.
Yeah, 5. All right.
Does anything else count?
Add it up.
That was all of it.
Here, I'll cash that
out. Yeah, I'm going to cash out a little bit.
Pretty.
A little easier. There it is.
All right. 44.
37.
22.
53.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think, Nikki P?
It's interesting. It's good. There's not as much combat as you initially think there's going to be in the game. I don't know. I like all the parts and pieces and the trying to get what you've got to work for you. There's some timing things, as usual, that I didn't quite get right. I felt like I started out pretty good, but then something got messed up.
Well, I don't like that it's benefits to target the weakest player. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like it's cheap points as far as I'm concerned. That part I don't like. Because she was hurting. I mean, I'm sitting over here with the pile of stuff.
Right. But that also means no one wants to attack you, right?
It doesn't matter. I mean, the thing was is... I didn't get in here again, you know, it's like I can never get in there. It's very difficult to get to the factory for me in this position. I played this position twice now. But it's rough. That part's hard. I didn't mean to take away from you there, Nikki. I didn't like that part for you. Because it's like she's 22 points.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She also opened herself up to that a little bit by being the first person to attack and spend
all
her power.
Well, that is her thing. I understand that.
I understand that. But
I just don't... I'm not blaming you guys. I'm just saying the game favors attacking a weak
person.
Pounding
on the weak person. I agree a little bit.
Well, for me, that attack was purely to finish, get this card.
Sure.
It wasn't to
for
get...
For 1 star. Right.
Anything. I know.
Well, 2.
Well, the stars are good.
What she was doing was that 1 star, right?
No, winning the combat was one, and the objective was
right,
a second.
I understand.
So it was a two-star move. I mean, the truth of the matter is, when you retreated to here, right, if you had just stayed here or retreated to here...
Yeah, you have more strength.
At least you're in your tunnel to knock him down to. I don't think that would have stopped
you. It would not have.
Because the problem was you were here.
Right.
Yeah. No, yeah.
And once that's happened, maybe your next move needs to be bolstered.
Exactly. That's a read on who should I attack. Mm. Not Lincoln. He can spend all that power.
Well, seven of it, but yeah.
I understand.
But it wasn't, for me, my choice of attacking Dave right here was the land he was on. It wasn't about Dave.
I got that.
And the resources were a great steal.
You went here.
Yeah.
Well, I had to go around.
Right.
Oh, right.
And that forced me into having...
Believe me, I wish you could have gone here.
And not taken the resources.
I'm
amazed you got them back.
Because my second card, which I wanted to fulfill, was controlling three... field.
Farmlands.
Three farmlands.
Yeah.
So I was going around here to get this one, and then my other guy that you got that was here was heading over to this farmland. Mm. So he wasn't going to go get... He wasn't going to attack.
Wow,
he was
weird.
Going
two farmlands
to
right next to each other.
Yeah.
The farmlands are hard.
I have to cross water to get to them.
Well, it's just an odd one. I mean, do they do that elsewhere?
I kept staring at farmlands. I'm like, those are the easiest ones to get to me. This one looks close, but my crossing ability doesn't get me
there.
I have to go like around, and then I could have used a tunnel and come and bothered you, but you were pretty built up on those spaces, so it was the easiest for me
to do. For you, the way to do it would have been here to here, then over there, because you can cross to the wood.
Control three tunnels, which I was never going to do.
Mm. Mm. Were you trying there? Is that why you were doing a little bit of that?
No, I was going to be... I could.
Because I saw you angling. I thought you were angling.
Control three forest was my thing. The reason that I thought about moving here was that was a forest, and I had this one, and I could get to that one. Mm-hmm. So on one move, I could get my objective. But the problem was, A, I didn't want to lose the popularity, because I was so close to that track, right? And I knew that every time I hit this card, I was going to gain a popularity. Mm-hmm. It was just tough. You know, I have to assume that part of what makes the game shift in that regard is those objective cards. And do you try to do them or do you not try to do them? I probably should have maybe not tried to do my card. I really don't know.
Right.
You know? What did you think, Link?
Well, I'm going to go to Aaron, the winner
first.
Let's see what he thought.
Well, I like it quite a bit. I agree with Nikki that it is not... You said maybe it even says that in the rules, that it's not. There's not going to be as much combat as you think.
Yes, it does say that.
It feels like it's a dudes on the map and expanding your empire kind of, game. But, you know, we had four combats total in our game, and I think that's reasonably typical, at least for a four-player game, three or four combats, maybe five. I like the asymmetricity of the different factions and your faction board. I like that a lot. So even if I played red again, it wouldn't necessarily be the same, you know?
Exactly.
Right. I also like, this is almost like a Stonemaier trademark where you really want to be good at a few things and not spreading yourself too thin to everything, right?
Right.
So I was, you know, I concentrated on combats and enlisting and mechs, and so buildings really didn't matter that much to me. Even though they have a big endgame score, it's like you start heading down one path and it behooves you to continue it.
Right.
Not to, I want to do one enlist and one upgrade and one this and one that. Like, that's not going to get you your stars. And it also leads, I really like that stars system.
Yeah.
And it also leads to, you know, now I've got three. How am I going to get these last three? And it lets you...
How do you get to three?
Well, I don't know. Ask Nikki. By fighting things.
This is the most stars I've ever had in this game.
Two.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe
so clearly I don't know what I'm doing.
Maybe that's your character, though. I mean, there definitely is a thing.
Well, yeah, you have to adapt. So right. The way this works is you've got to figure out how this benefit, also hindrance, because this gives you hindrance with the way that you can move and what you get for strength. So everybody has slightly different benefits and detractions against them. And then you have to figure out how to make that work. So my guy needs to be able to even build mechs, I need ore, or metal. So I either had to trade or I had to get over here. And to get over here, I had to build a mine for me.
Right.
Because I wasn't going to get what I needed. I don't have oil or ore or metal here. And those are the two things I need to actually be able to shift what I can do. and they're all over on the other side of the map. You know, it's not terribly far, but it's on the other side of the map. It's difficult to get over there, so you have to figure out how to get around there.
Right.
It's very interesting. I really like about this game. This is the second time I played it, and it makes you think, like, you're done with the game, and then you're immediately, like, thinking about it all night long. Mm-hmm. You know, it's right. got mm-hmm. that kind of a really compelling system that really, really is exciting. I mean, this is what's insane for me. I couldn't get into a position.
Those are all your combat cards?
Yes.
Wow.
You guys never gave me the opportunity. I mean, it was, you know, that was the downer. I was trying to get it together.
He's got a five, a four, and a four.
I have two fives.
Two fives and two fours.
Two threes.
You could fight me here. I mean, I was sitting there for
right.
a while.
But I had an objective.
Oh, you wanted that first.
He was
doing that. That was very difficult, right? And I was getting that first.
You mentioned what I think is almost the key word for figuring out this game, which is adapt.
Yeah, like absolutely.
You almost have to, every turn, just go, okay, now Lincoln's a little closer to me, so do I want to attack him? Yeah. Now I'm on a wood space, do I want to produce? Like, really, you have to adapt to the ever-changing situation on the board. And you can absolutely have a long-term strategy, you know?
Absolutely.
Right. But you really have to do, like,
you have to figure out, you might have to exactly zig when you're originally going to zag.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
And I did not do that very well. This, I mean, these are just, they don't count for anything in the game.
Which is a downer, believe me.
And
I was accruing
them. For my faction specifically, that's a waste, because these are resources to me. So there's an argument to be made that you almost should upgrade this first. And instead of bolstering, every
to
time
just
you
start
go
getting
here,
combat
hit
cards
for two
resources?
Cards. And yeah, because you could just, first off, they're resources, and secondly, they can't be stolen from me.
Right.
Right.
Well, that you can steal from us.
Right. Right. And if I steal the card from you, that's a resource.
That was the other reason why I didn't want to necessarily attack.
Attack him.
I mean, I wanted to, but I didn't want to give him a five or a four.
Right. Oh, yeah.
A lot of that depends on what your player mat is. So, for example, your player mat for the bolster is the two upgrade, right?
I don't understand the question.
Your player mat for bolster is two upgrade.
No. Move is two upgrade.
Oh, thank you. Your player mat for move is two upgrade. What's yours for bolster?
Enlist.
Oh, and what was yours for bolster?
His is deploy a mech.
Deploy mech, yeah.
For how many?
For three.
Three.
Oh,
okay.
Why? The one we didn't use, is bolster a two upgrade. And the thing about that is, if you bolster and hit for a card, then this is basically just a one upgrade. Because every time Crimea goes to this spot and takes a card, you already have half the resources you need
for the upgrade
thing below.
Need.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Because that's how Crimea works. And because I didn't care about upgrades, I had this thing where I was going to try to get all of my enlistments out.
Which you did pretty quickly.
Which was, yes. And in fact, I did exactly the mistake you said, which was I didn't adapt. I got, essentially for this strategy that I had in my head, I got the worst encounter card I could. I wanted an encounter card that there's so many that would move that thing forward, and I got something that made me go in a different direction. And once I went in that direction, I could never get back. And building this was that mistake. Instead of this, I could have had a second mech on the board.
Right.
And once I've got that and my ability to move around the board, so I was stuck here for a long time. I did what you were talking about, Lincoln, which was, because you did the same thing, right? Which was you build that mine early, and that gives your ability to get out and go places, but it just from the way
everyone
else.
I didn't really get very far. And I bypassed that encounter.
You
so
have to build that mine, right? To get out and get to tundra and mountains.
The interesting thing was, as we kind of figured it would happen, nobody made any alliances or bribes during the game. It seems like a weird.
It seems open to abuse and, if anything,
absolutely.
Kind of a drawback to me. I'm happy the way we played.
Go ahead.
So sorry.
No,
it seemed like it was kind of just thrown in there at the end of making the rules.
I haven't played enough of Jamey Stegmaier's games to know if that's something he likes. A lot of people like that kind of stuff,
right?
You know, negotiation aspect.
Well, for example, it looked very clear that you were going to end the game, like at least two or three turns ago, before the game was over. I guess that would give the three of us a chance to gang up on him in some way if we wanted to.
Which I would hate that. That is not something I enjoy.
It does. It
in
feels
games.
Wrong for what this is.
Right.
Yeah.
You know?
We should have done it, though. I mean, come on.
In hindsight, sure. So apropos of nothing, I just want to go back and say one thing that I really appreciate about this design is the popularity track changing your victory point allotments and awards, I think, is really an interesting thing. You know, you're the only person who broke into this second tier, yeah, which made all your stuff a lot more valuable. But I really think there's a...
It's the only reason I was even close to you at the end, right?
I think there's a strategy to be pursued to, like...
If this had been swapped, I would be now... I'd be in third place for sure.
You think
and Lincoln
so?
Would be closer. Yeah, totally.
But if anybody had gotten up here, you can just win on those points alone, I think. I mean, I'd like to see a game where somebody tried that just to get their population as high as they possibly could.
It's difficult,
and
though.
See what happens. There is... I'm sorry, in another game that I played off camera, one of the factory cards gives you a pretty good way to boost up your popularity, like pay a dollar for two popularity or something like that.
Okay.
So there definitely are strategies to push you towards that.
That move would give you, Lincoln, 9 more gold.
Really?
Yeah.
Just going up one.
What was your score? Do you remember?
30. It's 37.
Okay, so you'd have 46.
I might have said 30. No, I think I said 37.
Yeah. So you would have had 46. I had 44. So you would already do better than my score down there, and my dropping down there would cost me one.
Well, I was trying to get there. I thought, well, he's going to end it on the next turn. There was no doubt in my mind.
I just like the. I like that.
I think it's really
neat.
Yeah. I actually like that you want to try. I mean, it costs you for things. Like it costs. I never even got to spending the popularity to do upgrades.
Cost you to produce. It can cost you on encounter choices. It costs you anytime you touch
someone's
worker.
That was the other reason why I didn't want to. At least at this point in time,
right,
to attack that, I knew. I'm like, I'm trying to at least get up to the next level.
You could have gotten there, but that's also... You could have gotten here on your next turn. If Aaron didn't end the game, I was actually leaving that space.
Yeah. I really like that leaves your workers as a shield. Like, oh, well, Lincoln doesn't want to go to that space because it's going to cost him 2 valuable popularity.
This crushed me as well.
Really? Having them go back home?
I can't get them out. It cost me my entire movement. Yeah. Because they're not there with a mech.
Right.
That was my problem. And I'm not allowed to build a mech here.
Right.
If I could deploy a mech here.
Right. Or
this
even
is
move
not
in and pick them up, which you can't.
Right.
That really hurt.
It's a big hit even with the penalty attached.
Right.
Yeah.
It's not as long as the mech goes back, or if it's early, or if I had upgraded movement, or if there's just one. I mean, there's all kinds of ors to that,
right.
But...
There is all kinds of...
There is a lot of ors.
Oh.
Boo. No.
Scythe.
So thanks for teaching us, Dave.
You're welcome.
Did you notice his guys are Kid from Kid and Play?
Oh my God! With
I think
flat
they're all
tops?
Just wearing different hats. Is what it
they
is.
They are.
He's Bob's big boy.
Yeah, I'm like. No, I'm like the fat boys breakdancing.
Yeah.
Mine are definitely wearing berets.
You and Lincoln's are very similar.
Mine's a chef dude. He's like.
No, yours is like a beret. Ours are pretty similar.
So
mine's
you've
like
got
pointing.
The arm out or something.
Yeah.
Popping
for a gun.
That's your Pillsbury Doughboy.
The Pillsbury faction.
Oh, we're just wasting gold, you guys. We're wasting gold.